Rij naar toe te ken. Dames en heren, Jacques Reinhard.
Je moet gesê die baaskoop is hier.
Die raaisel oor waar Jacques Reinhard om tans bevind verdiep. Volgens die politie is daar geen spoor van Reinhard in Johannesburg.
Wat peel uit Jacques Reinhard se kotsemmer?
Sy ex-uitgewer haat hom.
Wil sy?
Jacques het net geweet wat goed is vir hom, as hy dalk nog hier. Wat doen jy? Sy selfoon, was daar nie dalk 'n leidraad?
Die laaste SMS was aan Lena Oukamp en Jan Paul Otto. Hy het net gesê vriende vir altyd.
Wow, Ballade for an Inkling is back on the big screen with a modern twist. It is a romantic mystery that focuses on a journalist who reveals the truth about the disappearance of a popular writer. The Afrikaans feature film, which was directed by Danny Bester, is such a hit that within its first week on circuit, it hit second position at the box office. Here to tell us more about the film, what makes it such a crowd puller, and all the things Ballade is, Danny Bester himself. Danny, good morning. Thank you very much for joining us.
Hey, yeah, great to be here.
Let's talk about something that a lot of us grew up with. I know Ballade for Enkeling. I know the songs. Where are we with this modern retake? What have you done?
I'm the producer. So
yeah, you're the producer. Okay.
Yeah, but it was it was such a popular series back in the 80s and stuff, and people really resonated with the energy of the story or the spirit of the story. You know, it's about friendship, it's about being young and being in love, and then you know betrayal and all that kind of stuff. So it deals with like your real human emotions. You know, it doesn't matter how old you are or where you come from, we all experience those things, and the TV series really sort of like brought that together, and that's what we try to do with a new one. So it's a new version of the story, but it's the same story. It's new elements and all that kind of stuff. But it's still, you know, the same beautiful story that like made people feel a lot for people for characters in the 80s. Yeah,
I can only imagine that when you're working with something so nostalgic, that you've got to be almost respectful of it because it had a huge following, generation after generation. Yeah. It had some more screenings after the original series on SABC. Talk to me about that kind of, and how you approached something that you knew had history. You had to rework the music, you had to kind of keep the old themes but make it fresh. What were some of the things that you wouldn't change, some of the things that were holy, and some of the things that you said to the guys, look guys, we can scrap away with this and we can change that?
I think our main thing is we tried to keep most of the characters. It was also a 13-part TV series, you know, so there was a couple of characters that were sacrificed in the process. Mm. But we kept the, you know, the Jacques Reinhard character and obviously the love triangle, the younger versions. A big difference between the TV and the feature film is like we've got a younger cast and an older cast, you know, so that was a real challenge in casting the film. But I think it also paid off beautifully, you know, so... There was a lot of challenges, but we, as I said again, we tried to be pay honor to what it was, and we tried to stay true to the spirit of what it was.
For those that haven't seen it, is Gavin in there?
He makes a small cameo. Yes, yes.
Talk to me about when he walked onto set for the first day. I mean, just kind of, you know, he is one of the original guys.
Yeah, and he was such a heartbreak in the community and stuff like that. You know, he was a good looking guy. I'm not saying he's not good looking anymore. You know, but he's a little bit older now. But I just remember my sister, friends, everyone was in love with him. Most probably my mom as well. She wouldn't admit it, but everyone was in love with him.
Obviously, when you work on a production of this level, you've got to look at different elements. Yeah. A large part of this was shot in Mobbening. Why Mobbening? Yes.
We also, Jacques Reinhard is a free spirit, and he embraces Johannesburg and society, and you know, he's not... he doesn't come from. He's a new South African, and I think we wanted to set it in a place where we could include everyone and sort of make it. There's a very beautiful line where he says like I don't need friends, I need people with heart, and it doesn't matter who you are, if you've got heart, I'll hang out with you, and that's kind of like the message of the film in some senses as well. Yeah.
I can only imagine that as a team, when you see that your movie, something that you've worked on, mm-hmm. Blood, Sweat and Tears, reaches number two in the box office, it says that you've done something right. Yeah. But what was the goal? Was it just to tell the story? What is the spirit like in the camp now, now that it's reached number two?
One always goes on to make a success, you know, but I've always felt that, like, you know, you have to make a great film. If you make a great film, people go and watch it. And if you don't make a great film, like, people usually don't go and watch it. And it's not the fault, and it's not the marketing's issues and all that kind of stuff. So you have to be honest with yourself as well, you know. And we try to, but we try and do good stuff for our audience. You know, we really respect our audience, and we go, like, how can we? They're not. You don't have to spoon feed them and stuff like that. They're smart. You know, they want to be mature. So they challenge us as well.
Yeah. Casting. I mean, you talked about some of the challenges of marrying the young and the old cast, but you've got a great looking cast. What was the brief? Because, I mean, you've got a really good-looking cast.
That is a pretty good-looking cast. I think we are a little bit influenced by American, you know, lifestyle and culture and that kind of stuff. So
very clean-shaven.
We tend to cast quite pretty. But it doesn't matter. Like, everyone that's in the movie is really great as well. Like, and I think that's one of the biggest compliments is the phenomenal acting by the cast, and also the music. And then the writing. I shouldn't start, you know. Like, I think everyone did an amazing job.
I don't know what that process is, because I'm not part of that reality, but when you put out a film like this, and already there's questions, is there going to be a part two? Are we going to see Ballade for England 2?
There was actually a second part to the TV series and stuff. It wasn't as popular as the first one, but we've started talking about it. Like, Leon van Europe was the writer, is the writer, and he's a prolific writer, you know. So I think he's already excited about it, and he'll most probably start working on it on his own. And then, like, 3 months from now, he's like, "What about this?" You know. So maybe there will be. Yes.
So to the fans who are watching this morning, there is potentially a Ballade 2 on the cards.
Yes, we're definitely looking at it.
What are the numbers in the opening week? You've been around.
We're going into our third weekend now. It's doing really well. We're nearly on 5 million, and over 100,000 people's gone to see it. And it's a Afrikaans film, but it's just a really good film. You know, I watch all South African films, and if you love movies, it's not an easy watch. It's a nice meaty film to watch. But
what is the projected earnings here, if I can be that bold and ask?
Obviously, we're hoping for we hope to go over 8 million. But you know, if we get,
because you already hit 5 million in your third week.
Yes. So
while going into your third week.
Yeah. So if we get to 10, I'm not going to cry. You know, I'm going to be very happy. Maybe I'll cry of happiness. Yes.
Well, let's see. Maybe you hit 20. Anyway, it's in all good cinemas. It's all over the country, isn't it?
Yeah, nearly 60 cinemas, so it's virtually everywhere.
Yeah. Okay, you can get it everywhere. That's Dani Best, who is a producer of Ballade for an Enkeling. And he just gave us a taste of what you can expect in this movie. And there might actually be a number two on the cards. It's currently sitting at number two at the local box office. I'm going to tell you, get your family, get your friends. This is a great weekend movie. Go and check it out.